refrigerators and freezers. Introduction. Refrigerators and freezers are among the most important pieces of equipment in laboratories. They maintain a controlled temperature, environment for various fluids and substances. At lower temperatures, less chemical and biological activity is present so that fluids and substances are better preserved. Purpose. Refrigerators are used to store samples, reagents, kits, and quality control materials to ensure shelf life and stability. Freezers are used for much longer-term storage at significantly lower temperatures for microbial stock cultures, samples, reagents, and quality control material. Types. Different kinds of refrigerators and freezers are used. They can be grouped by temperature ranges. Conservation refrigerators in the range of 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Low temperature freezers in the range of minus 15 to minus 35 degrees Celsius. Ultra low temperature freezers in the range of minus 60 to minus 86 degrees Celsius. A unit with appropriate functions must be selected depending on the activities carried out in the laboratory. Principle. Refrigerators and freezers function according to second law of thermodynamics, regulating the energy transfer where temperature differences exist. Modern refrigerators and freezers are thermal systems, which function mainly using a cycle called compression, where refrigerant gas with special properties achieving heat transference is used. Key components. The following are featured as central components of the refrigerator control circuits. 1. The main switch. 2. The door switch. It turns on the light when the door is opened. 3. The compressor. 4. The evaporator's ventilators. 5. The defrosting subsystem. 6. The resistor subsystem for defrosting or maintaining the equipment's components free from ice. 7. The thermostat. Operation. Refrigerators. The operation of refrigerators is generally very simple. Each manufacturer gives basic recommendations. Some of these are highlighted below. 1. Connect the refrigerator's electrical feed cable to an electrical outlet equipped with a ground pole and the capacity to supply voltage at the required power. 2. Activate the on switch. Some manufacturers place key switches on refrigerators. Wait for the refrigerator to reach the operating temperature before storing any product. The manufacturers adjust the temperature of refrigerators at approximately 4 degrees Celsius. 3. Select the temperature at which the alarm must be activated. Follow the instructions provided by the manufacturer. 4. Load the refrigerator according to the capacity established by the manufacturer. Ultra-low temperature freezers. Operation of ultra-low temperature freezers implies following a procedure recommended by their manufacturers to achieve the conditions stipulated for the equipment.
The recommendations which are common to any ultra-low freezer are
1. Connect the unit to the appropriate electrical outlet with a ground pole exclusively dedicated to the unit. It must also be in compliance with the national and international electrical standards. The voltage must not vary by more than plus 10% or minus 5% from the voltage specification on the equipment. Select a location which has a firm and leveled ground in all directions. It should be well ventilated and away from direct sunlight or heat sources. The free space at the sides and back must be at least 15 cm from the unit. Maintenance. Routine maintenance of refrigerator involves
cleaning the interior. Before cleaning, empty out the refrigerator. Move the empty shelves towards the front. Dampen a piece of cloth with a mild detergent and clean by rubbing the surfaces gently. Dry and place the shelves in their original position. Do not use any strong abrasive solution.
the door gasket verification. Frequency, every 3 to 6 months. Gasket test. The door gasket is a component which must stay in a good condition for the unit to work correctly. To verify its condition, one must proceed according to the following steps. 1. Open the door. 2. Insert a strip of paper of about 5 cm in width between the door gasket and the edge of the refrigerator's body where the gasket is housed. 3. Close the door. 4. Pull the paper gently from the exterior. The paper must put up resistance when being moved outwards. If the paper can be moved without resistance, the gasket must be substituted. 5. Perform this procedure on 10 cm of gasket at a time around the entire gasket housing. A door gasket in bad condition produces various problems in the functioning of cooling units as it allows humidity to enter which condenses and freezes inside the evaporator. It increases the time needed by the compressor for maintaining the selected temperature. Affects the storage temperature. Increases the operational costs. Defrosting. It should be done routinely as decided by the laboratory. Many modern freezers have automatic cycles for defrosting the evaporator in order to avoid frost accumulation. Some models do not have defrosting cycles and the process is done manually on a scheduled basis. Defrosting must be done through the night, during which time the contents must be transferred to another refrigerator. Cleaning of the condenser. If the condenser is not clean, it'll interfere with the heat transference process and the refrigerator could heat or function at temperatures different than selected. Frequency, every 6 months. The electrical feed cable must be disconnected. Remove the protective grid. Remove the dust and grime deposited on the surface of the condenser. Remove and clean the filter. If too obstructed, substitute by a new one with the same characteristics as the original. Verify the functioning of the ventilator. Vacuum the condenser and its diffusive fins. Reinstall the protective grid and the filter. When checking the temperature in the refrigerator or the freezer as routine, the temperature should be monitored in different sections of various locations to include top, middle, and bottom shelves.